And the inquiry into the handling of the Bruce Lehrmann trial has been told. Police had a bizarre approach to the case. Prosecutor Shane Drumgold's lawyer also told the hearing the Brittany Higgins allegations would have been ignored had the alleged rape not occurred in Parliament House. Lehrmann's barrister, Steve Wybrow, also returned to the stand today, where he voiced concerns about the relationship between Ms Higgins and Drumgold. Bruce Lehrmann has consistently denied the allegations. He pleaded not guilty and the charge against him has been dropped. Joining us now is 10 News First reporter Alice Hogg. Alice, what did the inquiry hear about the way police handled the case?
Well, Sarah, a key focus of the inquiry so far has been on the relationship between police and the prosecution. And so Bruce Lehrmann's defence barrister, Stephen Wybrow, has been asked about his observations of that, telling the inquiry today that he wouldn't say that police were resentful of the prosecution and that his impression was actually the opposite, that he felt that the ACT's Director of Public Prosecutions, Mr Shane Drumgold, was hostile towards police. Mr Drumgold's barrister also made a different submission today, suggesting to the inquiry that Mr Lehrmann might not have been charged at all if it weren't for the publicity surrounding this case and also the location where this alleged assault is said to have occurred, suggesting to the inquiry that ACT police had generally been undercharging when it came to sexual assault cases.
Alice, it sounds so personal. It sounds like all the parties were really invested in it.
Yeah, well, that's been one of the criticisms, I guess, that Stephen Wybrow has had. He's been maintaining his criticisms of the DPP when Shane Drumgold made his public statement revealing that the DPP would not be pursuing another trial. He says that he was concerned that Mr Drumgold had aligned himself with the complainant, Brittany Higgins, and that through his remarks he'd taken a pejorative stab at his client, Mr Lehrmann, who had pleaded not guilty to this assault charge and maintains that position. The inquiry's also had some questions thrown at Mr Wybrow about a conversation he's said to have had with police in which it was apparently indicated that he felt that a person other than Mr Drumgold should have been responsible for making a decision about whether or not there'd be another trial. He says he then had a follow-up call from Mr Drumgold about that conversation and he told him that it was none of his business.
We know this case was thrown out after a rogue juror brought outside materials into the jury room. What more have we learnt about that?
Well, for the first time, we've been given access to the transcript of the exchange that this juror had with the Chief Justice. Once it emerged that this juror had brought in material from outside the trial, they brought in their own research. Through the transcript, we can see that this juror, who cannot be identified, expressed that they were deeply sorry for their actions, that they didn't realise that what they were doing was wrongdoing, and that they were willing to take full responsibility for it. Of course, we know that it did ultimately result in the Chief Justice aborting the trial and then, as we know, the DPP later deciding they would not pursue a second trial.
OK, Alice Hogg, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.